Hello everyone, I Harmeet welcome you all on WsCube Tech English channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about that what is the algorithm of YouTube. So let's get started. First of all, every search engine has its own algorithm, right? Like a Google search engine, you type something, you get your results according to your key search, right? But what would be the ranking of the website, right? What the content should be shown to you like very first, right? So that depends on the algorithm of Google. So same as on YouTube, whenever you search something out, what content, what video should be on first, what should be on second, or what video should be in your suggestion box or on your timeline. If YouTube decide this, and it has a particular algorithm to that. So basically, as you know that YouTube is a very popular place with billions of hours of video, right? There are billions of hours of video content available to there, and every second, every minute, millions of video being uploaded on YouTube, right? So it is like a hub of videos. A lot of data has been consumed by YouTube, right? So, and the main goal of YouTube algorithm, or what is the main goal of YouTube, is YouTube match every viewer to the videos they are most likely to watch, right? So this is the major goal of YouTube, that it wants to match each viewer with the most related, most relevant video, right? So in order to do that, YouTube has a particular algorithm. And what is that algorithm? Okay, so basically YouTube observes few things of your content, right? On basis of that, YouTube creates its algorithm, or we can say YouTube shows your audience your videos, right? So basically YouTube observes first of all the title of your video. Whenever you post something, or if anybody searches something related to that keyword, YouTube look for the title of your video. What is the title of your video, whether it matches with the key search of your audience, right? So title of video is being observed with by YouTube. And the description, what you have written in your description of that particular video, what your video is about, right? So YouTube basically observe that. And other than that, YouTube observe the popularity of your video and the popularity of your channel also, right? So how many views there are on your video or on your channel, right? So popularity of video, when I talk about the popularity, it doesn't matter that how many views you have, right? So the other things come, that is watch time. So the good watch time your video should have, right? So if your video is have good watch time, people have watched your video like for a longer time, then and YouTube shows us to the more people. So these things YouTube basically observe. And after that, the like and dislike ratio, the YouTube observe that how many likes you get on your videos, right? That's why we always say like a video, right? So that is the reason, like and dislike YouTube observes, and according to that it shows the audience your video, right? And the last thing it observes, that the comments, how many comments you have, or what positive comments you have. So on basis of these particular things, YouTube observe your content and deliver it to the related content, right? So you cannot directly deliver these your content to the audience, but YouTube does that, right? So even in the timeline, you have seen that there are many videos, many suggestions. Not all of them are from those channels which we have subscribed, right? So YouTube randomly put videos in our timeline that we are most likely to watch, right? So that's why these are the things that YouTube consider, YouTube observe for your content, right? For your channel. And as a viewer, for a viewer, these two things YouTube observe for a viewer, right? In order to match those two things, the content creator and the viewer, in order to match those two person, YouTube for channel, I have talked about that these things YouTube observes. But for a viewer, these two things YouTube observes, and according to that it creates their algorithm, right? So watching history, that what that particular person has watched already, right? Or what that person has searched, right? So basically if I'm watching all day I'm watching food related videos or food blogging or food recipes, then my timeline will be filled with the food related videos, right? Whether I have subscribed to the channel or not, right? And the watch time, it doesn't matter whether I click that video, right, and plays for the 10 seconds and then I can close it and it would appear on my timeline. It didn't happen like that, right? So YouTube watch my watching history, it observes my watching history and as well as my watch time, that how much time I have spent on a particular type of video, right? So that's why if you want to hold the audience, right, so make them watch your video like completely. Do not let them finish them before they finish your video, right? So these are the things, right, that YouTube basically observes as a viewer, for the viewer, and you, the content on the YouTube, or I can say the videos, right? So that's why I have always talked about that you should put focus on this, these things, and how you can write your title, what should be your description, how can get the popularity on that video, how can you can increase your watch time. That we are going to talk about in our next videos. So do subscribe to our channel, right? Because we are going to upload many videos in our channel related to the YouTube, because I have told you already that this is a premium course. Every information, everything related to YouTube, you're gonna get on this particular channel, right? So this is a complete series, right? So this is a particular course. So if you do not want to miss any video, do subscribe to our channel, right? And in our next video, we're gonna learn so many things, right? So if this video was useful for you, then hit the like button. If there's any suggestion, any comment, you can just comment down and do like this video. Thank you so much.